PCOD. So what is PCOD? Polycystic ovarian disease. And what is PCOS? Polycystic ovarian syndrome. So I'm asking one question from you. Do you think that you are diseased? Are you a diseased person? So the answer is obviously no. You are not a diseased person. You are not a diseased person. So PCOD is an old term. PCOS is a new term. So remember that actually both are same. So do not confuse whether you are suffering from PCOS or PCOD. So let's come to the signs and symptoms. What are the signs and symptoms that you can recognize whether you're suffering from this or not, whether you should go to the doctor or not? So let's come to the signs and symptoms one by one. If your periods are too much disturbed, so what type of disturbance you can expect in your periods? If your period doesn't come, like if your period comes in every 3 months, 2 months, or if it gets late by 10 days, 15 days, or if your period is coming on time but bleeding is very less, or if period is coming but it is continuously bleeding, means too much bleeding is there. Sometimes patients are coming that and they are not getting even their periods for a year. So any type of disturbance in your period, you should check yourself whether you're suffering from PCOS or PCOD. And the second sign can be if you are having excessive hair loss, then you should check yourself whether you're suffering from PCOS or PCOD. The third sign may be if you're having too much acne. If too much acne is there on your face, on your back, on your chest, then you should check yourself once definitely whether you're suffering from PCOS or PCOD. So these are a few signs and symptoms. If you're facing some blackening of your skin on the nape of the neck, on your some face, or some blackening type of skin under the arms. So these are also sign of PCOS and PCOD. So I'm not saying if these are present individually, then it is necessary that you have got PCOS, but it may be possible that you are suffering from PCOS. So check yourself. So another sign, what can be the sign? Many our patients come to us, just only they are having extra growth of hair on their central part of the body. So central part of extra growth of hair, like upper lip, chin, and in the central area of the body. So if you have got extra growth of hair on the central area of the body, then you should definitely check yourself whether you're suffering from PCOS and PCOD. And what other disturbance you may face? Many a times patient doesn't face any problem before their marriage. They are absolutely fine. Their periods are absolutely normal. They never face any kind of excess hair loss, any kind of excess hair growth or acne or any type of such problem before their marriage. But after marriage, they present with infertility. And when we check them, then we find that they are suffering from PCOS. And due to PCOS, they are facing infertility issues. So infertility is one of the biggest problem in PCOS and PCOD. So all those patients who are suffering from any of these kind of problems and who are in their 20 or between 20 to 25 years of age, so I'll request to their moms and I'll request to these patients as well, go and do your checkups properly at least once, because this is your life. If this is there, then it cannot be treated. Yes, this is the truth, that you cannot completely cure your PCOS, but you can control your problems. So if it can be controlled from the very initial point, that will be beneficial for you. So go and check yourself whether you are suffering from PCOS or PCOD. If you are having this problem, check yourself by your doctor if you are suffering from this, because this treatment only doesn't include medicine, because natural and medicine, both treatment, if it'll take simultaneously, then it will work. So please, from today onwards, watch your symptoms. If you are having any kind of such problems, if you are having too much acne, if you're having too much extra loss of hair, if you're obese, and remember this thing, so roughly 70% of the PCOS patients are obese, and roughly 25 to 30% PCOS patients are lean and thin. So those patients who are lean and thin, those patients who have got weight just 40 or 35 kg, 45 kg, and they think they can never get their PCOS or PCOD, please don't think like that, because roughly 25 to 30% patients are suffering from PCOS who are lean and thin PCOS. So go and check yourself with a good PCOS specialist whether you are suffering from PCOS or PCOD. Because according to me, if you get diagnosed on time and you have got sufficient time, so yes, you cannot cure your PCOS, but you can control your problems. So get control over PCOS and be cautious about your symptoms and take care of your symptoms if you are having all these problems. So remember two formula. One is do not be your own doctor. First, go and check yourself properly, deeply, how much disturbance is there inside you. because these are just symptoms, but disturbance is there inside you, your hormonal disturbance. So check yourself under the guidance of your doctor, not just go to the lab and check yourself your PCOD hormones or PCOS. Many of the patients are doing like that. They're just wasting their money. So don't do that. Check yourself under the guidance of your doctor. What your doctor is recommending, go and do checkup like that. And many of the patients are coming to me with so many ultrasound reports. I think just every 2 months they are doing ultrasound reports, roughly 20 and 30 ultrasound reports. With ultrasound reports they are coming and they are showing to me, ma'am, I have done so many ultrasounds. My sister is not going and my PCOS is not going. So for them, I'm saying don't do repeatedly your ultrasound. Because PCOS, you cannot cure your PCOS. So do not repeat your ultrasound again and again. If you are doing your ultrasound once in 6 months, that is sufficient. Because ultrasound is not the only marker or only parameter for your PCOS to be diagnosed, and for your symptoms and for your problems, how deep is the problem. To know this, your ultrasound is not sufficient. So do not repeat your ultrasound again and again. Just one ultrasound is sufficient if you have done it in last 6 months. So do not do your ultrasound every month to check how much your PCOS has gone. So this is not correct. So please check yourself at the right time, at your right age, so that if you have got these symptoms, it should be controlled. Because in my opinion, the most important problem that the PCOS patients suffer is infertility. What I consider is infertility, because roughly 50 to 70% of PCOS patients suffer with infertility. And what I think and what I do and what I see in my patients, that if these patients, they take the treatment right on in the right way and at the right age, then this infertility can be treated easily. So check yourself from now. So I hope with this session, if all of you are watching me, I can see the names, many of you are joining this session. So go and check yourself properly. And if you're having this problem, take your problem seriously. If you are serious for your PCOS, then PCOS is never serious for you. This is my one sentence, remember this thing. If you are serious for the PCOS, then PCOS is never serious for you. But if you are not serious for your PCOS, then PCOS is going to be serious for you. So be serious from today and take your treatment properly, because only medicines will not work and only natural treatment will not work, because we have to attack on PCOS from all the sides. So remember thing, attack on PCOS from all the sides, not from the one sides. So just one side attack will let the PCOS go from the PCOS will leave from the other side. So initially we have to attack on the PCOS from all the sides. And once all the symptoms are controlled,